Hello everybody and welcome back. My name is Nawri Radwan and this time I'm not on the screen like I used to be. The reason why is because recently I had a surgery. It went fine, I'm doing okay, but that will not stop me from creating new videos. Before we start this tutorial, first, Abby has something to say.
Abby here to let you know how you can get over 500 photo manipulation assets delivered to your inbox every month. Photo Manipulation Premium is here, a monthly hand-curated drop of stock images designed to help you build your resource library up fast. This month's drop is fantasy, containing over 500 of our beloved high fantasy figures, 3D assets, and landscape stock images. You do not want to wait. Not only will this drop be gone for good on April 7th, but if you join now, you'll be locked in at that early bird price. Check the description for more information, and I just wanted to let you guys know, so on with the tutorial.
The first tip that I want to share with you guys is a selection tip. I will show you how I selected this trail, this grass, as you can see right here, in a way that you don't have to add details on the selection edge. I will demonstrate that tip on that image right here. I want to select that trail right here, that path, without selecting that grass. So what to do is, first I will click 2 times to take that lock. Now, I will click on Control A to select all. Then I click on Shift Control C. Then I click on Q until that layer turns to red. Then I will click on Shift Control V to paste. Then again, I will click on Q to exit the quick mask mode. Then I will add a mask to that layer. And then let's click and hold Alt. Then let's click on the layer. As you can see, it's created that black and white mask. What to do now is I will select the brush tool and make it soft. Change the mode to hard mix and just start paint on the edges of that trail. Then click on Control M and take that slide to the left side. Paint whatever details that are left on that trail. As you can see, it gave us a really good details on the edge of that selection without the need of painting them later. And that will help blend that trail on your artwork without the need of doing all of that masking and painting and all of that extra work. If you have a character that is standing on a surface that's a mud surface or a grass surface or any surface that has a lot of bumps or displacement details, like my character right here, it's not blending well with the surface that it's standing on or he's standing on. To fix that, simply just add a mask to your character layer, and with a soft brush, make sure the hardness is all the way down to, let's say, 20%. Change the mode to dissolve or dissolve, and with a black color, paint on the bottom of your character layer. Then go to filter, click on blur, and then click on blur. Simply just by doing that, you can merge the layer, you can merge your character with the surface that it's standing on. If you don't want it to be blurred too much, just go to filter, sharpen, and click on sharpen edges. You can always go back and add details or erase some details. If you have an object on your scene that has light direction, the opposite of the light direction on your artwork, in my case, this tree right here. As you can see, the sunlight is hitting from the right side, while in my artwork, the sunlight is hitting from the left side and it's soft comparing to that hard light. To fix that, click on the layer of that tree right here. As you can see, this is the tree. Then click on Control A to select the whole canvas. Then click on Shift Control C. Then click on Q. Click Shift Control V. And you can see that red color that appears. Then click on Q again to exit the quick mask mode. While the selection is active or highlighted, add a hue and saturation adjustment layer. Then simply just decrease the lightness. That already gave me a good result. If you want a better result than that, just click on the layer mask, then click on Control M, and you can just increase or decrease the contrast between the lights and the shadows to make it even darker on the light area. If you think you made your object a lot darker, you can simply just increase the lightness. On my haze layer right here, as you can see, it's affecting all of the top area right here, but it's hiding a lot of the tree details, and I don't want that. I want to be more contrast on that tree. To fix that, simply just go to the tree layer, make a copy from that, duplicate that layer by clicking on Ctrl J, click on the bottom one, then go to layer, layer mask, and click from transparency. That will give us that layer mask right here from the object. I will take it above all the way up to that haze layer, and then I will click on Alt and hold it and drag it to the haze layer. First, let me remove that lock layer, and let's do that. Now, as you can see, the haze layer is only affecting the tree. To fix that, click on Ctrl I to invert the selection. But now there is a lot of contrast on that tree. I want to be less contrast. To do that, click on the layer mask and decrease the density right here. And that fixed the problem. You can do that to all of the layers at the front that you don't want to be affected by the haze or the atmospheric layers. And that's it, everybody, for this video. I hope you learned something new. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, show me that by clicking on the like button. Also subscribe to this channel for more tutorials like that in the future. Follow me on my social medias and check the links in the description for that subscribe plan. And I will see you in the next tutorials. Peace.